Hello, technology lovers, wherever you are. Today, President Eisenhower deeply valued the strategic benefits of the U-2's airborne reconnaissance during these tense Cold War times. And now the call came from Lockheed's customer in Washington to build the impossible of an aircraft that can't be shot down, and do it fast. Kelly Johnson, one of the preeminent aircraft designers of the 20th century, and his Skunk Works team had a track record of delivering impossible technologies on incredibly short, strategically critical deadlines. The U-2 was but one example. The group was known for its unfailing sense of duty, its creativity in the face of a technological challenge, and its undaunted perseverance. This new aircraft was in a different category from anything that had come before. Everything had to be invented. He committed Skunk Works to succeed in its toughest assignment to date. The speed of the new aircraft was to exceed 1,000 miles per hour. Other planes of the era could, in theory, approximate that speed, but only in short, afterburner-driven bursts. This new plane needed to maintain a record-setting speed for hours at a time. At such velocity, friction with the atmosphere generates temperatures that would melt the conventional airframe. The original Blackbird was designated the A-12 and made its first flight on April 30, 1962. The single-seat A-12 soon evolved into the larger SR-71, which added a second seat for a reconnaissance systems officer and carried more fuel than the A-12. The SR-71's first flight was on December 22, 1964. Reducing the size of the Blackbird's radar image meant an even further reduction in the likelihood that the plane would be perceived and shot down. Though the initial test results were good, rumors of Soviet radar advances led the U.S. government to ask for an even smaller radar profile. Then a full-scale model of the Blackbird was hoisted on a pylon for radar testing at a Skunk Works secret location in the Nevada desert. With tests carefully scheduled to avoid Soviet satellite observations, the results were impressive. The Blackbird model, more than 100 feet in length, would appear on Soviet radar as bigger than a bird but smaller than a man. The team had succeeded in reducing radar cross-section by 90%. Thanks for watching.